Okay, so once again I repeat, is there any problem in submitting assignment 4, 5, or 6? Because there won't be further extensions to that on the Moodle website. If you want to resubmit it now, then I will give the permission to resubmit it. Otherwise, you have to submit through your email. Through email, you please send your assignments either to me or to the sir. Am I clear for this one, please? Those are attending the session now. I haven't received my assignment 3 marks. See, regarding the assignment 3, I am in the still correcting those assignments. Let me show you the status here once. Hold on. So another MCA students, around 53 are 53 means minus 3, around 50 students have been in the pending state. Why? Because it's taking long time to check every assignment of this. Why? Because you are submitting the assignment at around 80 to 100 pages. So let me show you one example here. This is an example. Okay. Is Rupesh available? So this is around 287 pages.
Yes, sir.
See, you, of course, we asked you to submit the code along with the outputs. But here, in the screen output, where is the screen print for selecting a particular country that you are displaying the information for that particular country? You have just put the world map here directly.
Yes, sir. I had not done that. I had only give the facility of selecting the whole map after selecting that.
That's what all your code is like this, of course, without even the logic comments. So your feedback over here. Okay. Question 4 and question 6 also. So this is just an example I'm showing you. So I need to go through this 287 pages. Of course, I have to quickly go through like this only. But anyway, just to show the others that why it is taking this much time. Not only you, even for other students also the same, similar case, around 212 pages for each student. So this kind of problem is there. So it will take a little bit time. So those people, you can just see your feedback comments, screen prints question of question 4 and your comments in the logic. So please go through this properly and you try to, if you can possible, you can correct yourself so that you will not repeat it again. Okay, with respect to integrated MTech students, the assignment 3, they are submitted in the lab. Of course, for a couple of them already completed those. 3-4 students, I think. Yeah, another 11 students are pending. So hopefully by today evening or tomorrow morning, I'll try to complete this. But now the question here is, my important question is there any, for anyone, any problem in submitting the assignment 4, 5, 6? I think some more are now trying to join with us. Just hang on for a couple of minutes. Sir, I have not submitted because not completed yet. Rupesh, that's what I'm telling you. Now there won't be any further extensions from the Moodle course pages because we cannot now leave it like that. We cannot extend it for more number of times. So now what I suggest to you is before 30th of this month, please submit it through email, the PDF document with your file name, either to me or to Satish sir, please forward it. Okay. Before 30th. After that, yeah. So before 30th, please submit your all your assignments. Okay, right. And those you already submitted here, we are evaluating it, and we'll complete it by the next week. And you can see your assignment marks as well as quiz marks. Okay. So apart from this, Rupesh, any other person is having any problem here regarding the assignment submissions? Okay. Now coming to, see here already, we are almost near to the end of the semester, and let me put the syllabus for you. Just hold on. Okay, so I hope you are able to just go through this syllabus once. Of course, the last week I had a quick run on this one. So if you look to unit wise, in each unit there are different topics. So all these different topics, we have already, these are all the highlighted topics which we have completed. Okay, so only the pending things are on the Ruby on Rails, GoJS, and Firebug. These three topics are remaining here. Now I will just upload the Ruby on Rails. Little small material is ready, so I will just upload that. And let me just upload that also and just come back to you. So the video lesson and the other PPTs of Ruby on Rails, I will upload it by tomorrow.
Nagendra,
sorry, sir.
When you are sharing the screen, I don't know it is an issue only for me or for everybody else. It is fully zooming out, zooming in. And then I see only the top part of the screen.
Oh.
Is it the case only with me, or like is it with everybody else? Occasionally your full screen comes, and then like whenever you are typing something, it's coming there. But immediately it is going to the top left part of your screen, fully zoomed.
Is this problem persist for others, please? No, sir. It's fine for me.
Okay. Right. Perfect. Then it's an issue with my browser. I'll just try to restart one more time.
Yeah. Just clicking to this. Okay. So we have almost completed the syllabus. Before I proceed further about the unit number 5, I just like to hear from you all, please, those who are attending the session now. So of course, the material is given. It is in a synchronous mode of delivery. This teaching learning process is on the asynchronous mode. At least you might have seen the difference between asynchronous and synchronous. I'm not trying you to just compare those two modes of delivery. But nevertheless, people have tried a lot. I think they put some efforts in trying to find out and solve those exercises with the little information that what we have given over here. But now, the point to be noted here is the amount of time, the amount of exercises, the amount of work you have done. Of course, these are all minimal things that you might have done or you might have learned something. So there is a, because these are technologies, the technologies requires a lot of innovations, a lot of what you call, of course, these are not disruptive technologies, but they are nevertheless, they are the technologies for various purposes, for various application development, basically your web applications, internet technologies. So now this internet technologies course will definitely, I hope most of you have got some insights about the idea and what is it all about, and where exactly you know it, you know the pluses and minus, you know yourself what, how far you are able to do those things, and the confidence levels on you, you know very well now. The only thing that I would like to hear from you is, see, Keshav Kapoor, are you online, please? Keshav Kapoor, Keshav Kapoor, here there is one person called Keshav Kapoor.
No, sir, he is not online.
But his name has been seen here on the list of people.
He's there.
Oh.
Oh, yeah, sir, sorry.
Okay, I will wait for him. But anyway, see here in the syllabus, shall I go about going through the unit 5? Because we have still some more time is there here. See, you will have another, including this week, we have 3 weeks totally. So this week I can go through the Ruby on Rails and GoJS and the Firebug, of course. So you have another 2 weeks of time for to complete these topics. What is your plan? Will you be able to digest these topics? Means digest in a sense, will you be able to go through this one or not? Yes, please. I'd just like to hear from MCS students. Please, any one of you can take initiative. Your CR is, of course, I don't know who is your CR till, of course, the semester is coming to an end. By the way, have you appointed or have you looked for your CR? Yes, please. MCA students. Because it will be easy for me to later to communicate to you all. Yes, Rupesh. Rupesh.
Yes, sir.
Who is your CR, class representative of your section? Sorry?
CR. CR is Ayush Pandey, sir.
Ayush Pandey.
But yes.
I think today he is not attending. Ayush Pandey. Okay. Anyway, so I would like to hear from you, those are attending now. So shall we go with this unit 5 or not?
Sir, will we be evaluated on unit 5 as well for the quizzes and major?
Yeah, of course. If it is to be considered, then we are going to include that one. So my idea is, personally, what I think Satish sir also may agree. We will give the material, but we will not give any evaluation questions from this unit. But we will give the material to you. We will provide the material on the course web pages. Is it okay? It is up to you. If you are interested further to explore and to know what is this search engine, Google search engine, how a search takes place, and how Google keyhole markup languages are being used. Of course, this particular topic, this fifth unit involves both theory as well as practicals. But practicals, we will not stress much on, we will not go in depth on that one. But of course, but you will come to know what is called keyhole markup language, KML, which Google uses on Google Earth. You might have seen the Google Earth application. Have you seen Google Earth application? Anyone?
Yes, sir.
The satellite images and the ground map images will come usually.
Yes, sir.
Google Earth application itself is there. It is not a web application, rather. But and another important topic is on search engine and their algorithms. So how your Google search has evolved, and what is that searching mechanism which usually happens? So there are some how the ranking takes place, and how the in the initial days how Google displays the search results. But nowadays it is in a different style. So just a little bit of ideas on that one. We will provide the material, but we will not give any questions on this one. Okay, this is the most. That's what I feel it. Still, if you want to include, then it is fine. We will anyway. This topic is going to be taken up in the next week, so we can have a discussion over this. Now coming to this, all the four units. See, all the four units will be there for your the final quiz. And of course, this is an external examination. So what is that final quiz is? This, let me, the revised version, which we have kept it on 6th November. Let me show you, this is what, for those people who have not attended those sessions or not seen this particular evaluation strategy. Okay, so your quizzes, your assignments, is this, this is for your MCA students, please. Okay, and your end semester examination for MCA students. So before the last instruction day, you need to submit one mini project or major assignments, which can be of your topic. And there will be an open book test. So there will be the important announcement here is we are making this as a 20 marks and this as a 30 marks now. To be uniform with all other courses. So that's what the change here comes here for you as well as for integrated MTech students. So integrated MTech students, you have a quiz. Okay, that quiz is basically for your 20 marks and your open book test will be there for your 30 marks. Am I clear to you here? Just 5 marks is taken from this quiz to, and given to this component, open book test. There's a change in that 5 marks. Integrated MTech students, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So, yeah, MCS students, what about you? So here, the end semester examination, that is in the end semester examination, this open book test will be for 30 marks. And this mini project, whatever you are submitting, it will be for 20 marks only, not for 25. Is it acceptable, please? Of course, integrated MTech student, the CR has said yes.
Yes, sir.
I'm just, Ayush Pandey is not there. I expect that others also are okay with this. The MCS students.
Yes, sir, it is fine.
Yeah, so 20-30, that is a proportion for your end semester examination. So please submit your that mini project before the last instruction day. So I expect that it need to be completed by, you can say by December 5th, you please try to submit it. Okay, MCS students, by December 5th, you please submit your mini project or your assignments. Anyway, I'm discussing with you, if you are having any concern or any issue, please let me know now so that I will not put the on writing on the course page. So by, I'm expecting your MCS students to submit your mini project by 5th of December. Similarly, for integrated MTech students, integrated MTech students, you need to submit your the lab practical exercises. Okay, so this exercises in the sense your design and development of this one, either or is going to be existing here. Of course, we said that the solution has to be submitted by 30th November, but don't exceed beyond this 30th November. The last date will be obviously 5th December. Is it acceptable, integrated MTech students?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so you keep this deadline 30th only for you, but at the maximum you can go up to 5th December, not beyond 5th December. Okay, so these are the changes here. If there is any concern, please let me know so that I will update this on your course page. Once this meeting is over, I will update those changes. Now, coming to another important point, so we plan to conduct one quiz exam, which will be very similar to this component. The component here is, see here, all of you, there is going to be integrated MTech students, they're going to give a quiz here for you. Online submission of quiz answers. It can be short answers, MCQs, match the following, fill in the blanks on the entire syllabus before the last instruction day. So this particular 20, this is now 20 marks, okay? This for this 20 marks. A dummy quiz of similar type, we are planning to conduct on Friday, this coming Friday. And of course, the topics will be up to your JSP. Not, it doesn't include this week particular topics. This week particular topics means Ruby on Rails, GoJS, and Fireball. Except these three topics, all other topic except these three, all other topics will be there in that dummy quiz. It will be a practice session for you, and the marks will not be counted. I'm telling you, it is just a practice session, and it will be given 1 hour time. Within that 1 hour duration, you have to submit your answers. Integrated MTech students, please. Am I clear for you? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So that please prepare your topics and you try to answer those questions. We will give you the formats and everything. So read the instructions and that will be like your some kind of rehearsal for your that examination for open book test that is going to be held at the end semester. For MCS students, So is it acceptable for you, or is it okay for you to write those tests along with those students? Why I'm telling is this because those students who could not submit your assignments, there are a few students are there in MCA. So those students who could not submit your assignments, you can as well attend this particular quiz, and that will be considered for your assignment marks. Okay. Hello. For MCA students, I'm talking about.
Okay, sir.
So those who could not submit your assignments and of various reasons, health issues or your laptop problems or internet, whatever it may be. So that particular exam, you have to write it along with this integrated MTech students, and that marks will be counted for that. But now this coming Friday is only a dummy test. So you can also attend this dummy test. So this dummy test does not consider for your marks. It is only just a dummy test for your practice. For those who want to write it for the later stage. MCA students, are you clear with this?
Yes, sir.
So please inform to your friends. Please inform to you. Only now around 35, 36 students are there. Of course, just less than 50% of the class. So please inform to your friends, those who want to consider those quiz marks, those who are unable to submit those assignments. Because I could see out of 80 students, around 67 students only submitted the assignment 3. It means 13 students are not submitted, especially those 13 students are your MCA students are there, around 10 to 13 students. So for them, there will be benefit. So one chance has been given. So you please inform to your friends, MCA students. Inform you all your friends. Can anybody take this responsibility to inform all of your friends, either through mail or phone or whatever it may be? Because Ayush also is not there.
Sir, we'll forward in our college group.
Please. Okay, you forward to your college, I mean your class section, and inform them there will be a quiz will be considered for replacement of those assignment submissions.
Okay,
those who could not submit assignments, they will be, that marks can be considered from that quiz. But this Friday, there will be a dummy quiz. Dummy quiz in the sense that for you to practice, for your practice session only.
Okay.
So the next week will be the actual quiz exam, the next Friday, coming next Friday. Okay.
Okay.
That Friday, that particular marks, whatever the marks you get from that particular evaluation of that quiz, it will be counted for your evaluation under that assignments marks for MCA students.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, please inform that particular point, very important point. We will not miss that opportunity. Yes.
Okay.
Sir, what will be the syllabus?
Which syllabus?
For that page, sir.
That's what I'm telling you. That is for this dummy quiz, you will not have this Ruby on Rails, GoJS, and Firebug. But for that particular quiz, everything will be there except Unit 5.
Okay.
Rupesh, am I clear to you? Except for your final means the next week, next Friday. The next Friday is, anyway, I'm going to put this on the course page. But first I will discuss, I would like to discuss with you. Then we will come to the course pages. So that next quiz will be on the date. December 4th. Yeah, it will be on December 4th, Friday. The quiz which is going to be conducted on December 4th, it will not replace all the six assignments. It will be whatever the assignment 4, 5, 6 is not considered, for that marks will be considered. It will be scaled to that. If you say, Ajay Kumar Soni, quiz marks, basically some have submitted two assignments, Some have submitted 3, some have submitted 4. Some have not submitted 3 or 2. It means some have submitted only partially. Those partial marks can be counted from the quiz marks.
And sir, what about those who have submitted all the assignments on time and?
Assignment marks will, as it is, will be there. There won't be any replacement for that. There won't be. It is not like a better of those two things. That's what I'm making you clear, making you to understand. This is an opportunity for those students, who could not submit those assignments. Assignments so of various.
Attend, yeah. Yes, sir. So we have to attend this quiz.
It is up to those who have submitted assignments. It is up to you. If you want to have a practice, you can attend it. Otherwise, no need. It is not compulsory.
Okay, sir. Okay.
It is not compulsory. That's what I'm making it clear. Only for those students who could not submit the assignments, there is one opportunity is given. They should attend those quiz. That quiz will be consisting of all the topics, all the syllabus. All the means almost except Unit 5, all the topics will be there in that. They have to come prepared with all the topics.
Sir, this 20 mark quiz will be on December 4th.
Yes. Only this week it will be a dummy quiz. Dummy. We want this dummy quiz. Why? Because we like to see if there is, we like to see if there is any problems which are going to come. Before we want to foresee if there is any issues that are going to come. This is the only thing. Because now, see here, 35 students are attending this one, this online session. This is a different one, but you like to see it on the Moodle directly. So even today, I observed that on the number of users which are there on the Moodle at a time, around 35 students are there. Now 16 students are there, of course. So 35 to 40 students, there won't be any problem as of now. That's what I could see. But what if, in case, if all these 60 people will come, means 60 to 70 people will come, if they, we, because that case study, that testing case has not performed. That's the, I want to see that part. That is just to only have a testing, that is a test case. More users are there on the online at a time. More means around 70, 80 students are there online. What is going to be, is there any issues going to arise or not?
Sir, in either exam, the pattern is same as quiz or it will be a paper type?
Sorry?
Major external.
Yeah, okay. Major external, that particular point I have written to you here clearly. Here, you mean to say OMC open book test?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So this will be an online submission of answers. The test duration will be shall be around open book test this year. Okay. So test duration shall be around 6 to 8 hours. We give it to you to submit it. It will be a write-up. So don't expect MCQs, fill in the blanks, short answer questions. When an open book test is there, the open book test will make you to explore the information that we've been asked in the from the question. Basically, the questions will be of practical nature. It will not be a direct question. So it will not be a direct question in the sense it will not say what is what is MongoDB. It will not be like that. What is PHP? What is the use of PHP? It will not be like that. Okay. So the application oriented questions will be there mostly. So you need to figure it out, the answers. You can use any of your books or your online sources and all. You will see the questions. You will have a test of that, an open book test of this course, how it looks like. But one thing I can assure you, it will not be a direct question. It will not be an exercise question from your textbook. So for that to prepare a question, we have to put a lot of efforts. That efforts, we will keep it from our side.
And it will be your 30 marks, sir.
Right. 30 marks.
And
in the entire syllabus. Entire syllabus. Except Unit 5.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Sir? Deepak. Yes, please. Yes, Lucky.
Sir, there is little bit confusion in that the quiz of 20 marks will replace major assignment or minor assignment for MCA.
What is major and what is minor again? I have not used these terms at all.
Sir, means mini project will replace mini project or
mini project is remained as it is.
Okay,
mini project will not change at all, Baba. This end semester exam for MCAs, only 20 here, the change is 20 and 30, that's all. Marks change here. 20 marks here, 30 marks here.
Okay. Quiz is for 6 assignments you have given to us.
Here I have written here, quiz is for 6 assignments.
Okay,
no,
okay, sir.
See, assignments are 6 only.
Yes, sir.
I'll tell you. Assignments are 6. Now assume that you have submitted only 3 assignments.
Okay, sir.
Now what happened to other 3 assignments? When I ask you, you said you are sick and you could not submit, and your laptop is not working. Some, because there are excuses are there already. Some of them have sent emails to me. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now only 3 assignments, and if I take the average of those 3 assignments, the marks will come down.
Yes, sir.
Just to give one chance for them, now the 3 assignment marks can be considered from that quiz marks whatever you obtain. We will normalize that one. You don't worry about that. We will explain in what way. First, I would like to see whether this is acceptable or not. Then otherwise, we will not consider this opportunity. And then we will keep it as it is, those 6 assignments. If you accept this one, then that formula realize the formula can be obtained for that 25 marks, how many assignments you submitted and how many marks the quiz you have obtained in that one. Out of that, how many marks you obtained, that is going to be normalized to the remaining 3 assignments.
Okay, sir.
That that formula we will explain to you anyway. You will get that justification. We will after the evaluation is over for those students who have made an attempt. Not for every. We are not doing this exercise for everybody, right? For some students, there are only 2 assignments. For some are 3 are there. For some are 4 are submitted. Because it is a variable, now that formula we have not obtained here. Okay, those are only for only 4 or 5 students, Saman. That is not more than that. Okay.
Okay.
That is all.
Thank you.
And I told clearly that those who already submitted 6 assignments, there won't be any replacement of that one. Forget about that. You need not worry about those things. Like Mohammed Farhan is there, he has not submitted anything. He is attending the classes now.
Yes, sir.
Have you submitted the assignments?
Yes, sir. I submitted assignment 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4, sir.
What about 5 and 6?
Sir, I will submit till 30, sir.
Okay, okay.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, I think he has, in the beginning, he was not able to submit it. Not only Mohammed and Imran Khan, sorry, Mohammed Imran. Mohammed,
yes,
Imran,
sir.
Was there. Yes, Mohammed Imran has not submitted anything. Yeah, sorry, I was confused with Mohammed Farhan and Mohammed Imran. Imran is there. Do you know what is happening to Imran Farhan?
I don't know, sir. I think Sagir knows, sir. Sagir knows, sorry? About. Sagir Uddin Akhtar, maybe.
Okay.
Sagir Uddin Akhtar.
Yeah, Sagiruddin may be knowing. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So anyway, he has not submitted an assignment. That's what I was saying. Who has submitted and who has not submitted. Deepak Kumar, sir, I missed quiz 10 because I was not well those days and it's closed now. No more extensions, Deepak Kumar. See, anyway, 2 choices are given to you out of 12. You are considering only best 10. Okay. So now because that deadlines are not going to be extended, we cannot open for one student like that.
Sir, so when will the open book test be conducted?
That schedule will be given to you all. From the school it will come. So on a particular day, you will have internet technologies exam. So that is an internet technologies. That schedule will come to you.
Okay.
That will be planned across the institute. Okay. So we will not have control of that.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, Mohammed Farhan, tell me.
where we submit the last two assignment on Moodle late assignment, or can I mail you, sir?
You have to mail me now. There won't be further extensions. That's what I'm telling. Please mail to me only, or to sir.
Sir, on Moodle, there is an option late submission. You are late 2 hours, something like this.
You see, it is there, but we don't want to extend it now. If I have to extend, I have to extend it for all, and again, there will be a lot of confusions for us.
No, sir, I'm not talking about the extending. Like, sir, there is that option for me to add submission, because they're like writing like you are late for 2 hours or 2 days, something like this. So can we submit here, or I can mail you?
Submit it. If you get that option and you have the option, you submit it. No problem.
Yes, thank you, sir.
Yeah, any other doubts, please, for clarification regarding the evaluation? So once we wind up, so the changes will be on one thing. Let me just put these changes now only here. So this before the last instruction day, I am putting that is before the last instruction, that is the date deadline I'm keeping. This is on 4th or 5th December, I think.
Sir, can you increase the mini project submission date by 2 days or 3 days?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sir, please at least up till 10 December, please, sir.
December 10. See, after December 10, there won't be any extensions for you again. That will be
yes,
very
sir,
hard
after,
deadline.
Yes, sir. After 10th of December, we will not tell you to extend.
So at least if the 10th is on Thursday, so but I can give up to 7th December. 7th December is Monday, so at least Saturday, Sunday, you try to complete and submit it. Okay,
okay, sir. Okay.
7th December, we don't extend. I cannot extend also. The semester will be over, most likely after 7th.
Yes, okay, sir.
So 7th will be the, maybe it will be the last working day, I don't know, but you can, so beyond that, I cannot extend it further, okay? So this will be... The MCA students, this is for 20 and this is for 30, okay? And your quizzes and assignments remains the same.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, and this is the deadline for you to submit your things, that is your mini project. And for integrated MTechs is also for, this will be 20, 30. I hope you have seen these instructions clearly for the task for the integrated MTech students. So anyway, this is now uploaded. It will be uploaded onto this Moodle course page. So anybody is having any doubts, you can just refer to this.
Sir, when will quiz 8 be updated?
Regarding the evaluation of those two questions? You are looking for those evaluation of the two questions?
Yes, sir.
Just hold on, I'd like to see now. Hold on. Anyway, I'll keep it here only at the end so that you'll not get confused between this. So I put the dates also, the changes whenever it has happened, I put the dates. So that will be giving some clarity to you, the students who are not present for this discussion today. Okay, now coming to your quiz 8, right? Okay, I will do that one, but I don't want to show that to you now. So hold on. Meantime, if anybody is having any questions, you can just ask me so that I will do this process and come back to you. So what is that question number? Do you remember? Hello? Am I audible? Yeah. So here the question is, sir, I accidentally uploaded assignment 5 in place of assignment 6. Now it's not showing editor. So Deepak, just hold on, I'll come back to your problem. So, Ashwini Rupa, sir, XAMPP MySQL is not running in my laptop from half an hour. Design MySQL shutdown unexpectedly 4.12 MySQL. This may be due to a block code missing dependencies. So, how should I fix it, sir? Ashwini, this basically, is it running earlier?
Yes, sir.
No, only suddenly it has stopped functioning?
Yes, sir. I shut down my laptop and again after some time when I switched it on and tried running the SQL port, it was not running. Actually, there are more errors which have come. I just put a part of the thing.
Maybe the origin of the errors, I should look into that one. But anyway, you properly have not shut down. Why don't you restart that XAMPP?
I restarted it, sir.
Still, you are having the problem after you
Yes, sir.
Okay, can you connect your screen? I'll just check it.
Yes, sir.
So on quiz 8, somebody says question number 5, 8, and 9. Oh, it's question 5. Only one student has got correct this particular question. I'll just show you the statistics. Would just see here, quiz number 8.
Sir, you are not sharing your screen.
I'm just sharing. Just hold on. Just hang on. Yeah. See here. So quiz 8, question number 5. So this is what the students have attempted, and these are the marks they got it. Okay. One student on question number 5. Question number 5 is this. And that student is no, question number 5 is almost some people have got correct only here. 3, 4, 5 students have got correct. Yeah.
Sir, in that question, I used the function constructor for object instantiation.
Okay, for out of 71 students, out of 71 students here, 5 of them have got correct only, that question number 5. And those 5 students are basically Vani Gupta, Shreyans Rathore, Nikhil, Sachin, Ashutosh. Okay, now these are the students actually who got that correct. Sorry, is somebody saying something? Sir,
sir, my answer was correct, sir. I just put var before the object name.
Oh.
Like okay. var my iPhone equal to new phone of smart 4G iPhone.
That is in your JavaScript, right?
Yes, sir.
Be declared then. How come question number 5 it should be considered? No, actually quiz number 8 is the students were asking is basically there is a regular expression over there that is making problems. So question number 5 there is no problem here. Some students have got correct and it should be considered. We cannot change those marks. Now question number 8 and 9 I have to see. Question number 8 and 9.
Sir, in answer there is no where, sir. I put where. During string matching, it considered where as wrong and.
Oh, 8 and 9 also are there actually. Some have got correct answers actually. 8 and 9 also.
Some sir, in 8th question in the document.getElementById, in the answer the D was capital, sir. I put D as small, which it is actually in selector, it is small only.
Yeah, it will be small only. It will not
but in answer, it is showing capital D. Maybe
no,
that's
I will tell you what happened. You know, that is a mistake I told on that day only. If I clearly remember, maybe you might have not attended or others. But that is because of the copy paste problem I told on that day for those people who are not getting those marks. Copy paste, copy from which editor? I copied from the Word editor, Word file. See, when we prepare a question, usually our word file will italicize the cap, means the starting letters will be capital letters or it will be italicized. It depends on the format and the font which you are using in that editor. So when we copy that question and the corresponding options of that, so it will be copied. The editor will copy those with the format, the font options which are there, and that will be carried there. And Moodle will look for exact whatever you given in the options way. That is the problem actually. That's the matching. It was not having. So that was the problem. The 2 marks will be given for those students who have written a small letter or a capital letter. For that is the reason. came. So you do not worry about that. I will do that maybe by next Friday. You please check it. So anyway, I'll write down myself. That is the immediate thing I have to do. This is number 8, right? This is number 8. Question number 8 and 9. Right. Yeah. Any other things, please?
Sir, in 9th question, I selected the property of text content, sir. I mean, I use the text content to update the text to milk. You gave answer as inner HTML. Like, we can use both, no, sir. We can use text content and we can use inner HTML. So both are correct only, no, sir.
Inner HTML is one of the answer, actually. Inner HTML, you have to use, yeah, one of the property, you get it there. So you have used what?
Text content.
Yeah, it can be considered. There's no wrong. That is a problem. That's why these options, we have to be very careful when we give the next time. So anyway, we'll keep those things in the blank only. We'll not give the options those things. So this kind of ambiguity will be resolved. Yeah, any other things, please? So the rest, I think, you are clear with the resources, the materials. So just those are returning questions. Are you able to download all the materials from this year? And are you able to view the videos, perform the quizzes? Any other issues are there here? Hello? Hello? So if anybody is having an issue on downloading the materials or seeing the materials, URLs or videos or any things apart from that,
they are generally saying no for that, so it should be okay.
Yeah, that should be fine. So then it's almost done. Then we are so we will just upload the video lessons of Ruby on Rails and as well as GoJS. So this week, that will be the last topic. And of course, the search engines and the keyhole markup language, will put the notes for you. By next week. Next week, we'll keep the notes. Yeah. But that we are now, that that topics, the unit number 5, we will not be giving for your open book test as well as for the quizzes. Yeah, Ashwini, if you are able to share your screen, just present your screen so that if anybody is known is having any doubts, is okay, then you can continue reading the materials or it's up to you. So those are having doubts, please, Deepak, I accidentally uploaded assignment 5 in place of assignment 6. And now it's not showing edit or remove option. Okay, let me stop presenting the screen and I will give the option to you. Just hold on. Deepak Kumar, what is your ID?
MCMC 73.
Just hold on. So I have to update your assignment 6 now, right? I feel. So, Deepak, can you see my screen now?
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
Can you see my screen?
Yes, sir.
So I'm giving the option for you. You submit it.
Okay.
Now you submit it now only. I give you an option. Otherwise, I have to take out the option now.
Sir, right now I'm preparing, but not in PDF, sir.
So you are not yet ready. Then you submit it by assignment, means through email only.
Okay, sir. I submitted through email.
Any other, for anyone, any others, those who want to do resubmission, something like that? Okay. So, Ashwini, please, please, you please continue now. I'm stopping now from my side. Yeah, I'll stop. When you click the start button, what is happening?
I am getting this error, sir.
Again and again. So, better you stop this.
Sir?
No, completely you close this XAMPP control panel.
Sir?
You completely close this. You quit this control panel. Yes.
Yes, sir.
With that. Now you start again.
When I start MySQL?
No, it is started now.
Oh, yeah, no, sir. It's coming again.
Then see, it is having some conflicts there. Your port is being blocked, I think. The same problem. Have you installed any other thing apart from this?
No, sir. I haven't installed anything. It was running till the afternoon, sir.
Can you scroll up? Can you scroll up those errors?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Apache is running at 80. Apache is already running at 443. Oh, one second. That's enough. Scroll down.
Yes, sir.
Start my skill up. It is the detector running. Set is change detected. Stop. Can you just click that MySQL log file here? There is a logs button. Click that log file. Yes, my errors, error log file. Yes. Scroll down, completely go down. drag down completely.
Yeah.
Yeah. So at 512, your size of that particular file is exceeding now.
Which file, sir?
Oh, MySQL, the 12 MB. The writing the file full, please wait. So you are. Then waiting for purge to start, okay. Yeah. The same thing at 512 using atomic writes. You are writing that IBMT size is a. So it was working up to this 5 o'clock, right?
No, sir, it stopped working from 4 o'clock, right? At the beginning of the class, I started running it.
Then go top, little bit scroll up.
4:28.
4:10, 4:12 o'clock, you started using this one. 4:10. The problem has
Yes,
come at
sir.
4:10 also then. Okay.
Yes, sir. 3:50 also.
No, not 3:50 here. It started at that time before our means you said just during you said that around during that our session it was having problem. That's what I was
Yes, sir. I
listening.
started the thing at 3:55 at that time, I guess.
3:50
I
only you have
closed it at
started. Okay. Just
two.
to the, see these time instances will tell us what exactly happened during that time. That's why these log files are always to be monitored.
Okay.
Yeah. Monitored in the sense you have to now trace back what is your exact problem is. So I
Yes, sir.
suspect here the size of the it is this problem has started at 350 only.
Yes, sir. 3:51.
5, yeah. So now because at 156 also it is there actually.
Yes, sir.
So it is there in the afternoon, in the morning session. What about the morning session? You said that
Morning.
it is no, just scroll back. Yeah, just scroll back. When this problem has started, you have to go back to that particular point.
Yes, sir, at 3:51.
I see. At 156 also, if the same problem is there on my ear.
Okay. I was running at 156.
No, see here, the 156. Hold on, at 156 only. I could see this is see there is a rollback because there was a temporary table space. So this size to 12 MB, physically writing the word was failed actually. Size is now 12 MB here.
Okay. What size? I'm not understand.
I'll get back to you. But this problem is started not. This is at 156. This is at 1156. Even at 1156, the same problem is there. Further, you scroll yesterday also. You please go to the yesterday's file. Use yesterday's logs.
Yes, sir.
Your read write logs, buffer pool. So please, you have to go to that stage where your errors were not there. Just go to that error stage. Yes.
Okay, at the starting.
Not at the starting. You cannot go up to. You already 2 days, 3 days back also. This problem is there. It means this is the problem.
This is yesterday's.
So what were you doing today when that error has occurred? What is that inspection mean? What is the transaction you are trying to
Today I was actually trying. We have our DBMS assignment, which I was trying to do it today, sir.
do? Okay. No, what is that? I mean, so what is that operation you are doing? Are you inserting some data? Are you retrieving or
Yes, I was
doing
inserting and
something?
retrieving data, sir. Actually, yesterday I was trying to upload files to the MySQL, like picture files for the web crawling assignment yesterday.
Pictures you are assigning.
Yes, sir. Yesterday I did that one.
Are you able to store those pictures on the database tables?
Yes, sir. Yesterday it had run. It was storing it, sir.
What is the data type you have given for that picture storage element?
Long blob.
Long blob you have given.
Yes, sir.
But still, I think that has killed your memory space maybe.
Okay.
Now I suspect that basically it is related to the storage only, but something happened wrong actually. So can you go still you roll back, go to that log file still. Yeah, hold on there. Hold on.
Yes, sir.
No, further. Same errors are being seen again and again actually. Similar things are being shown here. This problem. Then that is not the problem which you will. Okay, just keep that log file there. Go to
Yes,
the
sir.
control panel once.
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, go to the programs.
Yeah. Programs and features.
Yes, click there.
Mm.
Go to MySQL.
Sir, by the way, those log files you are getting are perfectly normal, sir. Even for me, it's working and it's the same log files.
I think there is a thing, log file. XAMPP, you just restart that one.
Okay, sir. Uninstall or change, is there?
No, don't uninstall it. Okay. Go to the control panel once, please. Control panel.
Yes, sir.
No, sorry. Your XAMPP control panel.
Oh, okay. Yes, sir.
Go to config.
MySQL conf.
MySQL config, yeah.
My.env.
Open that. Just go to find and put what is the port number you have given here?
3306.
Change it to 3307. This is for the not there, can it? Find all, okay.
No, it is not 3.
It is there, no? 3306.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yeah.
Yeah, change it to 3307, both of the things, client and the server.
Okay.
Save it. Restart, yes, that MySQL now.
Okay.
Hey, did you save that one?
Yes, sir. I saved it. No, sir.
B308, you change the port number?
Yes.
No. What I suggest to you is,
yes, sir.
First you drop that one, 3308. Make it to 3308. Yeah. First you, okay, anyway, that is not running for you. Save this file. File, go to file.
Okay.
Save. Now close the file.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Start the Apache first.
Yes. Now MySQL.
Hold on. Okay. MySQL.
Okay. No, sir.
Okay, go to services. Yes. On the right side, you will see services. Click.
Yes, sir.
Go to MySQL. Hold on.
It is not this.
This is XAMPP, please. Jump.
No,
so when did you install this one? Which folder you have installed? Which folder have you installed this one?
In C drive, sir. Here, Zamp.
Even the Zamp has to show. Go to that services once again.
Yes, sir.
Control panel. Control panel, please. Yes. You are not finding the MySQL there?
Sir, no, sir. I am not finding MySQL.
Okay.
Sir, in Google, they are saying that you have to delete the IB data file, sir, for MySQL. They are saying that sometimes the file may get corrupted and the engines will
That IB data file, that 12 MB, it is exceeding actually. That's what I could see it on that log file. Probably persisting from long back, but she was able to do those transactions. But anyway, maybe various reasons. Oh, just please scroll up once again. Scroll up.
Yes,
go to Apache is there, is it?
Apache. No, sir.
Okay. So close the services, please. Close this.
Okay, sir.
Close this window. Yeah.
Sir, in my services also, it doesn't show this MySQL and XAMPP, sir. And I'm also using XAMPP. And I'm also getting the same log file. Since the beginning, I've been having the same log file.
That is not the error, that IBT1 only. IB temporary file. Because port numbers anyway, they are not having any conflicts there. Is your data is there, Amma, already on that MySQL?
Sir, I didn't.
Is already existing data is there on your database? Is some data? Are there any databases on that?
Yes, sir. I have databases.
Sir, what is Windows Event Viewer?
Whatever the apps are happening on your Windows machine, that will be listed on there. Can you go to the log file again, Amma? Please, can you just scroll on to your log file?
Yes.
Scroll on completely.
Okay, sir.
Just close this log file and open the log file again.
Yes.
Sir. Just scroll down, please.
This one.
Sir, in that XAMPP error log, it said to check Windows Event Viewer for more help. Once, can we see what it says?
Okay, let us do one thing.
Sir?
Go to your that exam folder.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Double click. Go to MySQL folder. Go to data.
Yes, sir.
Click.
Which one, sir?
Hold on. This one.
Yes, sir.
So you have my site too. You have test. You have crawling. You have course management system. You have company and assignment 6. So the IT lab. These are your databases, Amma.
Yes, sir. Workshop registration, MySQL, not MySQL, all except a performance schema and PHP my admin, sir.
Hold on there. So yes, this is started. Okay, you just delete this log file, aria_log_001, aria_log_control.
These two files.
Control file and 001.
Should I delete it, sir?
Yes, delete those log files.
Yes, sir.
So you restart your XAMPP.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Yeah, now it is running on that.
No, sir.
3308, it started.
And again, it showed the same, showing the same thing.
Come to this folder. Just come yes, to sir. This folder.
This one is created again.
Oh, that will create it, but that is, I thought those are creating some problems.
Sir, I think we should try and delete the IB data also.
IV, the temporary data. That is because the data will be lost somehow unnecessarily. Take a backup of these things.
What? All Which one, sir?
Databases, all these databases.
I don't have backup, sir.
No, no. I mean to say you just copy these folders into some other folder. Copy all you okay, give your sir. Databases into some other folder at present.
Yes, sir.
Wait. You have done really a bad thing. I mean, you will not be able to trace everything. Just go to your D drive.
Yes, sir.
D drive. Create a new folder and paste those things. Now, can you be able to trace like which of the folders you have pasted oh. here?
Yes, sir. Sorry.
See, now you can't even find which of them. You already messed it. Anyway, hey, you will learn from your mistakes.
Yes.
Another separate folder. In that, you have to dump those things. Okay. Anyway, you have kept it here, no?
Yes.
No, see, and also, like, you have not copied all the data. You have copied only few files and few folders.
Yes.
See, you have so many folders, so much of data. Just type Control A, Control A.
Yes, sir.
Control A, Control C.
Okay, the entire thing.
The entire thing, Control C.
Okay,
you are trying sir. To take the backup. Backup means like you need to save everything.
Yes, sir.
Okay, go to your new folder which you have created just now. No, not that one. In your D.
I'll create a new folder.
Another one. Yeah, okay. Better. You paste here? Okay, done. Okay, yes, now you do whatever you want to do. Whatever Nagendra session.
Yes, sir.
I was searching for some solutions on the net. Meantime, yeah, you just come to the control panel now. Now,
XAMPP
control panel.
Yes, sir.
Go to that config file of MySQL.
My.ini
initialization file. Find yes. Go to find 3306 now there.
I changed it to 3308 now. Sir.
Just search once again.
Okay. Okay, it is there here.
It is in the comments only. Go further down. Go for the next. Another
that's
one?
It. That's it, sir.
Yeah, no, just yeah, cancel and just cancel that.
Yes, sir.
Cancel that. Yeah, close the file.
Okay, sir.
Go to config button. Click the config button there. Mm. No, not this one. Not this one. The top.
Okay. Yes, sir. Got it. This one.
Yes. select the MySQL.
Okay. Auto start.
Not auto start. Service and port settings are there. There's a button over there. See.
So should I uncheck it again, sir?
Yeah, uncheck that one. Okay. Service and port settings.
Yes, MySQL.
Yes, select that. Yeah, 3308, you apply it, save it.
Yes, sir.
Save it again.
Yes.
Start those things.
No, sir.
Restart completely. From okay. The Apache also. Apache also start.
Restarted. No, sir.
Okay. Close that control panel.
Should I stop it, sir?
Yeah, stop it. You click that Windows button there at the bottom left.
This.
No. Now you type services.msc. Yes, open.
This one, sir.
Open it.
Yes, sir.
Can you able to find now MySQL here? Scroll on.
No, sir.
Previously, also the services are not being displayed here, right?
Yes, sir. Also, it's not displayed.
In general, MySQL is not displayed there, sir.
Even XAMPP was not displayed.
So installation steps might have taken different thing, I think.
Sir, one second. Can I tell something? To Rupa?
Yeah.
Okay, Rupa, so once on that start button, can you right click?
Okay.
There you can see top event viewer, right?
Yeah.
Once see there.
Okay.
There inside that, I think in Windows logs.
Okay.
There you should see an application administrator while.
You are on that only now.
I don't know. How did I see it again?
You click there.
There, sir.
Click that button, Amma. Your cursor pointing over there only.
Open.
Double click on it.
Okay.
So that some, error point. Those
there
errors.
Is some error in MariaDB.
Oh, you are already having MariaDB there. That's what you said. No.
I didn't do anything.
By default, it installs MariaDB some way. It doesn't install MySQL.
Go to the next error.
Information. Okay. Error, sir.
Error.
Able to initialize multi-master structures.
Roll down to that your 5 o'clock one.
Yes, sir.
So many errors related to MariaDB only. I didn't get all these errors.
Mm. I didn't install MariaDB. I mean, I didn't do anything.
Yes, but by default, when you install XAMPP, it installs MariaDB. So we were using MariaDB only till now. That's all.
You said that it was unexpectedly down, right?
Yes, sir. I mean, when I started running, it didn't start.
Can you open that INF file once again?
Yes, sir.
File once again.
Okay, this is error.
You can just keep like that only, don't worry.
This is error log, sir.
Oh, no. I'm asking about the config file. My.ina file.
MySQL config.
Open that?
Yes, sir.
Find for the word.
Which one, sir?
SIZE. Just type SIZE and find next.
Short buffer size.
Next, please. Hold on.
Oh, yes, sir. Should I go to the previous one, sir?
No, there only. I'm just looking that. I know DB buffer pool size was 16 MB, right? What was your RAM? What is your RAM on your laptop?
8 GB, sir. Yes, sir.
So your RAM is only 8 GB, right?
Yes, sir.
Now that you make it to there is a you 16 MB. Okay. Go to the next one. Find next. Scroll on. Just a little bit scroll on. Yeah. The next line. There may be several reasons this is they have to trace it out, but the log file is also not giving a specific reason for that. Just hold on for tomorrow morning. Okay, once I come to the university, I will get back to you.
Okay.
Let me just ice out and check it out. That making that problem.
Okay, sir.
Tomorrow morning at around 10:30, you can come through this email, then I will get back to you. Okay,
okay, sir. I'll mail to you at 10:30.
Yeah, 10:30.
Thank you, sir.
Anything else then?
Nothing, sir.
No, sir.
Oh, Nagendra has left. Okay.
Yes.
Nagendra? Okay.
He's left.
Right up. Okay. So
thank you, sir.
Catch you later. Okay.
Thank you.